Hello, Yunus here, and today I am going to show how you can scrape places from Google Maps with Outscraper. Firstly, you will need to open app.outscraper.com and navigate to Google Maps Scraper. I assume you already have an account. In order to scrape Google Maps, you will need to create search queries that will be used on the Google site. There are two ways you can generate those queries. You can select predefined categories and locations from the drop-downs. Or you can use Google-like queries and enter the queries manually or upload a file with the search queries. Google-like queries allow you to use links, place IDs, Google IDs, or simple text that you would use on a regular Google Maps site. Please note that it is necessary to use country and the city names in the queries, and I am the country drop-down. However, in our demo, we will use predefined categories and locations that will allow you to scrape the data even from the entire countries. I will select restaurants as a category, but you can use more categories at once. You also might want to quote categories. This is typically used when you want Google to return only those companies that match your category terms exactly. However, even with quoted categories, Google might add similar places to the result. You can use filters from advanced parameters if you want to eliminate those results. Now, I will select locations. As you might know, Google limits the number of results per one search to 500 items. Therefore, you can use zip codes instead of location names, as it will increase the coverage, especially in big cities. Moreover, you can drop duplicates from the result as some queries might return the same places. Congratulations! The basic parameters for the task are selected. Now, you are ready to start a task, or you might want to add emails enricher by selecting email and contact service. You also might want to check advanced parameters. Here, you can select the language, add filters, limit the places per one query search, or select the columns to return. Finally, you can tag your task and start it. You will see a rough estimate based on the number of queries, although the exact number might vary for different categories. You can set up a total limit by using the total results limit parameter. Once the task is created, navigate to the task page to see the progress. When the task will finish, you will receive an email with the link to the result file. That's it! Please visit outscraper.com for more information.